Yo guys, what's up? Morning. How are you? Welcome back to the channel. Thanks for watching. And if you like the content that I'm sharing here, please like and subscribe. Thank you very much. Okay, today I did not tell you that I actually changed my seats. So I guess the something I want to talk about today is, should you or should you not change to a bucket seat? And what type of seats can you consider for different types of purposes, right? Okay, so let me try to summarize this in a very simple to understand format. Okay, so let's have a look at my factory seats. So in case you don't know, there's a few types of seats that Mini UK puts onto their cars. So mine is a semi bucket. Why I say semi bucket is because it's still quite hugging here and here, and there's a bit of restriction here. Sini pun ada, sana pun ada. But it's not a full bucket because you can still recline the seats. And this is not the full sport seats because this has a separate headrest. So any of you guys, if you're using a JCW or let's say a 5-door Cooper S local spec, which gets the JCW seats, so you will not be using or getting this kind of seats. You're getting the red, black and red full sport seats by JCW. Okay, so this is the original seats. It's leather. There are some specs like UK or Japan that gets the same kind of seat, but it's in a fabric material. Definitely, it's harder to clean a fabric seat. Let's say if you spill some coffee or whatever stuff on here, it's very hard to get off. But if you're using leather, senang nak basuh, senang nak jaga. Okay. So for normal road use, of course, you don't really need so much effort from the seat. Okay, what you're looking for is just something more comfortable, thick paddings, cushion sedap, and you know, blah blah blah. But if you're going for a little bit more spirited usage or a bit more faster driving, a bit more aggressive driving, no, not to say aggressive, I'll just say, you know, a bit more spirited drive lah, because even I don't drive aggressively, but yeah. So anyway, so if you do need a little bit of help in the sense of the seat to hold you in place, macam ni, okay, like this guy here, so this holds my shoulder in place, so I don't move around when I take in the corner, the seat will hold me properly. And one more thing here is this part too. So can you see, it's the half of my legs is closed by this fellow here compared to this guy. So my legs can still move around in that seat, but not in this seat. So this is a full bucket seat. There's no recline, so it's a fixed position. So I just changed this seat a couple of days back. It's relatively easy. You just go and find the seat that you prefer and try to sit on it a few times. And the a bit tiring part is from fitting the seat in your car. Oh, you're annoying. I'm going to Sunway now because I need to readjust again the railing underneath your seat. Okay, because the railing determines the angle of your seat. So previously, when I first had the seat installed, I did not know what to look out for. So I didn't really notice the itty-bitty details like the angle of the seat, you know, the position of the front and the back, and the angle up and down, all of these things. So if you are considering to get a seat, there's many types of seat. There are actually a lot, like those very thick padding semi-bucket looks very nice, like those Continental shops. Like those Continental cars, like those Range Rover seats. Ooh, very very nice. But of course, in my context here, that's not what I'm looking for, because if let's say a comfortable semi bucket seat, lebih kurang sama macam my standard one. So why bother changing? So my concern today is because I want to have a better seat for my track day, and my day to day drive. And gatal lah. So if you notice something here. Okay, my steering is exactly straight now. So you can see the angle of my steering is like this. Okay. But then the seat is like that. Can you see? So I am guessing the front part of my seat is okay, but I need to change the back part of the seat a bit more like this. So the front is okay, just the rear part of the seat might be changed. So this is one of the things that you can you should look out for. Okay, and finally, benda yang paling annoying. Okay, so this is a sensor for your original seat's airbag. I'm not sure if you know this, but your seats also have airbags at the side. Okay, so now, in order for me to remove this, I'm supposed to have put back the adapter from my original seat, from the bottom of my original seat, back into the new seat so that this sensor goes away. You can also go to code this error out, tapi mahal lah. You have to pay a few hundred bucks. So no thanks. Okay bro, so I'm here today at Naga Motorsports. Nak datang nak readjust my seat punya railing. So Naga also sells these seats, and unfortunately I bought it elsewhere. This particular seat of mine I bought it dekat tempat lain. But okay, so benda ni lah yang you can adjust. So this the slider, semua benda ni, you have to make sure you have all of that. Some seats they don't have this, so you can't adjust the seat front and back. So you can also tweak the height of this one. So paling penting is you set this one correctly first. Angle kena straight, tak boleh sengit ke apa ke. And the height of it is also important. So previously the first setup, this one was a bit higher, so it's around here. So bayangkan my seat position was a bit macam tu lah. So bit weird lah. And then now apa yang I nak buat hari ni is, now it's like that. So I need, now it's like this. I need to switch it a little bit sengit like that. So this is going to take some time. Anyway, this is my new seats. Just toying with the idea because I feel like I need a better grip and better handling of my body inside the car. Oh, my car looks very Japanese, but doesn't matter. Function over looks, at least for now. So nanti bila ada duit sikit, boleh beli seat baru. So only this yellow thing is underneath, right? Tak ada benda lain tu.
Yellow.
So which part is it that needs to? I think maybe one of the lubang there that you need to plug in the blue color thingy.
But the blue color one is the bigger for this.
Anyway, guys, I will be doing an episode regarding tuning. So this is my recommended tuner, Active Tuning House. So yeah. Stay tuned for that episode coming soon. Just waiting this guy a bit more free, then we do the video. Okay, so after trying to dismantle the airbag sensor, tak berjaya. Now ordering something like an adapter. So nanti once dah sampai, then I will do lah. So anyway, just want to share with you guys. Can you see the gap here and the gap there? No? This is longer. That is shorter. So in a way, my seat is macam ni. So what I need to do is I need to make it like this. But I will redo this railing again lah nanti, one of these days. Waiting for the airbag adapter bypass untuk datang, then I will redo the railing together. But overall, I still feel it's a good investment lah. Really helpful in holding you in position. Wah, everyday mod lah. Hari-hari modify lah. You guys look at this wing. This is the most Japanese mini in the world. The most Japanese mini in this world.
Fastest
mini. Late color. So anyway, I'm here at RS Garage. I think this place has already become a Mini Cooper workshop. So this one repairing some knocking sound. Suspected, I don't know, I'm not sure what was it. Steering rack ke apa ke, but yeah. And another one, And another one there outside.
Mini Cooper workshop.
Okay guys, so I did not manage to record the final part of my attempt yesterday, which is to remove the airbag punya error code. Okay, and then I got the contact from the shop that installed my seats. So dia bagi I this guy. So I was talking to him, Muiz. So after chit-chatting, he saw the video of my original seats and whatever adapter that was there. So we went ahead and I got this. So tak tahu nampak ke tak. So basically it's an adapter to plug into whatever that's supposed to be plugged in your original setup. Okay. And it's only RM80. RM80 for one pair. So dia tak jual separate. So even I paid RM80 for the whole thing lah. So this one is the extra for my passenger seat, and then I already have it on my existing seat sekarang. Yeah. So I guess as a summary to all of you here, if you ask me, bucket seat, is it necessary or not? For me, I will answer yes. But if you don't go to track and you don't really toge so much, I don't think it's necessary. Tapi kalau you nak try pun still okay, you know, it does have the benefits. You just trial and error on different seats that you find. You know, you nak try full bucket like mine, or you want to go semi bucket. You can even also change seats not for racing. You can change seats because you want something a bit more comfortable. Pun boleh. Okay je. Let's say you want to preserve the original seats, for example. So you want to buy another more comfortable, more padding, more thicker cushions, semi bucket seat. Yeah, up to you, man. So hope this helps. So bear in mind, if you want to change seat, you have to transfer the seat belt punya thingy here. So you have to transfer this, and then you have to take care of the seat belt warning and also the airbag warning. So with all of these things said, hope you guys have a much easier journey in modifying your car seats. Okay, alright, thanks, cheers, bye.